So sometimes we feel anxiety, right? And this emotion is very uncomfortable. And our natural tendency is to do our best to avoid this experience, right? Do our best to, you know, push it out, to not experience it. And the more we do that, the more this anxiety increases, right? And it's just like we get into this spiral or loop of this kind of a negative loop, right? So how can one deal with the anxiety skillfully, right? And if we know how to deal with anxiety skillfully, we can also apply the same principles in different domains or different experiences or different emotions, right? So let's start with how does anxiety feel, right? So what is the form of the anxiety? So when I'm feeling anxiety, or when there is this underlying fear, so whenever I'm feeling anxiety, there's going to be the two aspects that is going to happen, right? One is I'm going to feel a strong sense of sensation in my body, right? Especially around my heart, it is more like, it's going to be kind of a dropping sensation, right? In the chest area, at least it happens for me. And there's an uncomfortable sensation in my body, right? Also, my thoughts are going to be very much around taking either some kind of a big step, right? I need to change my job. I need to do something like some big step, right? Or the chances are like I'm going to, try to distract myself from that emotion. So in that case, the thought will be more like I want to eat something, or I want to watch maybe some movie or something, so I can distract myself from that emotion, right? But this is more like a form of anxiety, right? A sensation in the body and the relevant thoughts, like more intense thoughts around that, right? So what happens if I follow these impulses, these kind of natural impulses, right? So if I follow these impulses, right, if I did something, like if I try to distract myself through watching some kind of videos, or maybe, eat something or something like that, what is going to happen is that is going to trigger another reaction. That is going to trigger, more like we have a judgment system inside our head. So that is going to trigger something like low self-worth or something like that, kind of a cycle will start, right? The more I react in that state, the worse I'm going to make the situation for myself, right? At the end of the cycle, I'm just going to feel bad about myself, right? So that is the form of the anxiety, and that is our natural response to it, because we don't want to experience it, right? So we just have, either we try to distract ourselves or we try to solve it with taking a big steps. And both of these actions are very unskillful, right? It doesn't solve the problem, and we are trying to run away from it in a way that is creating even bigger spiral for the same problem. So then how can we deal with it more skillfully, right? So it is given, this sensation is very uncomfortable, and we have like such a strong natural tendency to avoid it, right? It's not like we are trying to do it, it's just the natural impulse is to, avoid it. And it could have some evolutionary reasons behind it, but more experientially, first thing that we have to learn when we are dealing with something like anxiety over a period of time is we need to be able to sit through it, right? We need to be able to sit through the experience, right? Now, intellectually, it is not very hard to experience, but it takes practice. It is going to take some practice, right? Because our habits are other way around. So the natural... So in order to sit through it, there has to be, like, first of all, this deep understanding is whatever you are going through in terms of anxiety is a very impermanent experience, right? It's not like... Probably you have gone through much intense experience in terms of, even in terms of the same anxiety or even deeper fear, right? I'm sure you have gone through even a bigger experience, a more elated experience, right? So where you have this so much joy. But if you look back right now, you don't even remember them, right? They were just came and they just went away, right? But in the moment, in the heat of the moment, it's not like this, right? In the heat of the moment, you're not going to think like that. But at least have this deep understanding. Whatever you are going through in terms of anxiety is very impermanent. It's very, very impermanent. And sooner or later, it will just pass away, right? The more we react, the longer it is going to stay, right? So the one thing, if you want to learn to deal effectively, is learning to slowly be comfortable with this sensation, right? If it is too intense, you can just take a walk. But the best case scenario would be whenever this sensation gets triggered, you just sit through it. You sit through this whole movement of energy inside yourself. You will have a strong impulse to do something, but still you just sit through it. So that is a starting point, right? If we can do that, now we can solve it, right? Now we can look even deeper why something is anxiety. I'm not saying you sit through it and you don't do anything about it. If there is an anxiety, there is an emotion, that is a truth. There is something behind it that is triggering it, right? So we have to look into it. What exactly is triggering this anxiety, right? We won't be able to do it if we cannot sit through it, though. So let's say we learn enough mindfulness that we can actually sit through these emotions, right? Now, how do you know what is causing this anxiety? So anxiety is a kind of a fear, right? And behind every fear, there's always going to be some desire, right? There's always going to be that something that you think you want. So something you're afraid that is going to happen that you don't want, or something that you want is not going to happen, right? And these are the only things that are going to trigger this anxiety. Now, I'm saying these reasons are not like, impractical or not. I mean, desire has their validity, right? There could be desire for survival, and that desire is being triggered, and that anxiety you're feeling is actually a good information for you in terms of, look into your underlying cause, underlying desire, and see whether it is something valid and it is something relevant, right? And if so, then we want to take a decision appropriate to that. So it's always going to be some form of desire. It's going to be either, something I want and something I don't want that is going to happen. And it could be a little bit more complex, right? It could be like there could be multiple underlying desires that could, that could be triggered, right? So there could be many, many desires. Could be survival, desire for survival, desire for acceptance. And many desires could be triggered that we want, and they might be valid, and it's going to create this complexity, and that is going to be a little bit more challenging to peel back. And sometimes also, like, there could be a desire, it looks more surface desire, but underlying that desire there is something else. So we might have to go a little bit more, more deeper to see what is the real desire that I'm facing here, right? So that direct experience, or that direct that way of direct seeing something, allow us to be in a position where we can actually solve the root cause of the anxiety. And many times you will find there is no real reason behind it. It's kind of a hoax that is being presented to us, and in that case we can just shrug it off. And if it is something important that needs to be resolved, then we can take a more skillful action, more intelligent action, as compared to impulsively reacting and doing something which may not be very skillful.